بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم زدنا علما يا رب العالمين. We'll continue inshallah our program which is talking about التوكل على الله سبحانه وتعالى. To put all your trust upon Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And we still with our Prophet Muhammad al-Habib, the beloved one, sallallahu alaihi Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're still with him. And today, we just will focus about two ahadith, ayin Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which talking about the tawakkul. We took the ayat, the whole ayat, which talking about the tawakkul, for the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And now, inshallah, we'll talk a little bit about ahadith al-Mustafa, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have actually two ahadith. One hadith عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم narrated by Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. By the way, Abu Bakr narrated few ahadith رضي الله عنه. Umar ibn Khattab as well, وعثمان ibn Affan as well رضي الله عنهم وأرضاه. Because the ahadith in the Meccan period, they were like few. It's not like Medini hadith. Then in al-Madina, Abu Huraira came, and also the sons of the companions رضي الله عنهم, Abdullah ibn Umar, etc. Let us focus about this great hadith because nobody see this action except the Prophet and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were in the cave, then disbelievers came to kill them in the beginning of da'wat al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were just two in the cave, in al-ghar. Then suddenly they found, or Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu found group of disbelievers. They are standing in front of the cave with the swords. They only saw the swords. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, he was, you know, sad and afraid. Subhanallah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, لا تحزن إن الله معنا ما بالك باثنين يا أبا بكر الله ثالثهما أو ثالثهما. الله أكبر. Oh Abu Bakr, don't be sad. مَا بَالُكَ بِثْنَيْنِ. We are two. Imagine there are two and Allah is with them. Again, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. In Surah Al-Mujadala, مَا يَكُنُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُهُمْ وَلَا خَمْسَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ سَادِسُهُمْ. That if there are three people, the fourth one will be Allah. He knows everything. If there are four, the fifth one will be Allah. If there are five, the sixth one will be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kind of his qudra. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yesterday we were talking about the provision. The provision, a rizq, he is controlling it, expending it, expanding it, or limiting it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, al-Razzaq, al-Kareem, al-Alim, al-Sami' al-Hakim. Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was feeling at-tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Aba Bakr, la tahzan. Do not have this panic. Okay? Imagine that Allah is with us. والتخيل هنا على الحقيقة. The imagination here comes with the truth. Allah is with us. It's likewise that imagine that Allah is with us now here. سبحانه وتعالى. Allah is with us وهو معكم أينما كنتم. سبحان الله. The second hadith عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and great hadith, and this is inshallah my last thing here, and I'm advising myself and you to practice this dua. The dua before you sleep. Dua النوم. Allah great dua and very short dua. And show you at-tawakkul. Even ya Rasulullah, when you want to sleep, you say something related to at-tawakkul. Naam. Allahu Akbar. He said sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want to sleep, this hadith, by the way, this dua in al-Bukhari wa Muslim. If you want to have sleep, just say this short dua. Allahumma laka aslamt, wa bika amant, wa alayka tawakkalt, أنت الحي الذي لا يموت. Again, اللهم لك أسلمت. For you, O Allah, I'm submitting الإسلام. Okay. اللهم لك أسلمت وبك آمنت. I do believe in you. Right away, the third sentence. وعليك توكلت. I'm putting all my trust on you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then where is the power of Allah? أنت الحي الذي لا تموت. الله أكبر. You are the ever living, the one who doesn't die. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Short dua, even before he was sleeping, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was making this great dua. He had tawakkul even before he was sleeping. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's not only in the time of da'wah. It's not only in the time of difficulties. No. Even in the time of sleeping, he will have trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, putting the trust. Allahumma again, laka aslamt, the full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And bika amant, al-iman, al-islam, al-iman, al-tawakkul. Wa bika amant, I believe in you. Wa alayka tawakkalt, upon you, O Allah, I put my trust. Why? Anta al-hayyu alladhi la tamut. You are the ever-living, the one who doesn't die, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us this amazing and special and distinct feeling in our hearts. Innahu ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.